Everyone, welcome to Salesforce Codex. I'm Dhanik Lal Sahni. You can connect me on Twitter. My Twitter handle is Dhanik Sahni. In this video, I will explain you about Pseudodom. Pseudodom is a core concept for Lightning Web Component development. So let's start it with the agenda. First, I will explain about Pseudodom. Then we'll see what is benefit of Pseudodom. Then we'll see how to create our element as a Pseudodom, and then we'll see one demo. So what is Pseudodom? Pseudodom is a DOM inside another DOM. Whenever we create our web pages, we use a lot of HTML element to create that page. And when that page is rendered at a browser side, those element is tracked or created as a tree structure. That tree structure basically called as a DOM tree. With the help of Pseudodom, we can inject our custom element in that DOM tree. Whatever element we are injecting using Pseudodom, that is not going to impact on main DOM tree. Pseudodom has its own boundary, and they work on that boundary only. So if we see structure of our page, in the first box, we have a document tree we are showing. The tree structure is there. We have a normal element as well, and we have a shadow element as well. So whenever we inject our element as a shadow element or shadow DOM, first a shadow host is created. In that host, similar to our document tree, shadow tree or shadow DOM tree is also created. And so you can see parallelly, there are two DOM trees there. One is a main DOM tree, another is a shadow DOM tree. Whatever element, if I'm adding 5 custom element in a Pseudodom, so those all element is also creating a DOM tree in that our element. By default, those DOM trees, not Pseudodom trees, not visible. We have to enable it. I will show you where that setting is required. So once the document tree and a Pseudodom tree is created, you can see the flattened tree where the document is also available, and we have a Pseudo host with the Pseudo tree is also available with the Pseudodom. So let's see what is the benefit of Pseudodom. Pseudodom is designed as a tool for building component-based application. Like we have Angular, we have React.js. In these libraries, this framework, we can create a smaller component, and those component is included in a page at runtime or basically whenever we require that component. It also helps solving a lot of problems in web development. Like using help of Pseudodom, we can create an encapsulated or self-contained DOM structure. So whatever custom element which we have created, they have their own boundary. It is not going to interfere with others' boundary. Okay, like other in web page, we can create, inject, or we can use multiple libraries. So whatever element which we have created using the help of Pseudodom, that will not going to interfere with other libraries which we have included. So it's helped us in creating isolated DOM. Second, scope CSS. CSS defined inside a Pseudodom is scope to it only. There has one boundary. That boundary, that element is in that boundary only. The style of that rules don't leak out. Basically, whatever style we have written in a first element will not impact to the another element. Third, we have a productivity. With the help of custom element and Pseudodom, we can create a multiple smaller component for our user story or our requirement, and those custom element created by multiple developers. So multiple developers are working on the same page to work on user story. So the productivity of your application is faster than in a normal process where a single page only one developer is working. So productivity is also increased with the help of Pseudodom. So now see what is the process to create a Pseudodom. For creating a Pseudodom, we need to create a basically demo host, Pseudodom host, For that, we need attach shadow. Attach shadow API basically help us to creating a shadow host and shadow tree. In this attach shadow API, we can pass to one parameter, which is mode parameter. Mode is basically saying, do you want that whatever element which you are adding in shadow element should be accessible outside the boundary from the main DOM tree. So if you mark as open, it means it can be accessible. If you mark as a mode equal to closed, it will not be accessible outside our boundary. Once that shadow root is created, we can inject our element in that shadow root with the help of shadow root.innerHTML function. So let's see this code in action. So what I have done, I have created one custom button with the help of custom element API. In this custom button, first I have created shadow root with the help of this.addressShadow API. After that, I have created some styles. If these styles and one button element is added in our root shadow root element with the help of innerHTML. And after that, we have injected our custom element with the help of custom element dot define API. So you can see the custom hyphen button is our custom element API name. Let's see how we can use this custom button API. In this API or the page, I have created one normal button, and then I have created or used that custom button. And after that, I have also created a button CSS class. So this CSS class should be applicable for all the buttons which is available on that page. So if you see the shadow DOM, our JS library, we have created a button element. Ideally, it should, whatever the style we have applied on the page, it should override our custom buttons style also. But see how that's rendered at a browser side. You can see both button has their own style. Netty button has his style, and basically a custom button has their style which is applied in our library or the custom button, custom element API. So let's see this as a view source. If we see this custom button element in our view source, you can see the custom button is created, and in that custom button, we have a shadow root created inside. In that shadow root, all the style element is also available and our button element as well. So it is a separate encapsulated element, and style of main page is not overriding our custom element API. So whatever custom element we have added as a shadow DOM is encapsulated one. In one of my project where I have used Lightning Community Builder and I have used Live Agent in that page, in Lightning Community page or Lightning Component, I have used Bootstrap API, Bootstrap CSS classes. That class was overriding Live Agent's chat button. So that button was not visible because the Bootstrap CSS is overriding my Lightning Community CSS. Now that problem is resolved with the help of shadow DOM. Salesforce has created all the element as a, basically they have injected as a custom element as a shadow DOM. So no one can override Salesforce elements on the fly, or other library cannot inject their CSS in our Salesforce elements. I hope you got the idea of shadow DOM and its benefit.